Hey, what is up? My name is Rubidium. Today we are talking about lenses, cameras, and how to do this and actually make it mean something. So I don't know what the technical term is for this. I've heard it called finger frames, director's hands, but a lot of people do it on set to sort of like frame up where they think they would like the camera and what lens they would like on. The problem is that not very many people know what this translates to as far as lens length or camera placement. So I went out and did some testing and I decided to learn what my lenses look like through the finger frames. And it's a really great process. I think everyone should do it. You should learn your lenses, understand, you know, what a 16, what a 24, what a 35, what a 50, what a 120 looks like, and what the field of view of those different lenses are. So how you can do this is I've got my C200 here. I've got the monitor rigged to the side of it. So you know this secret little hieroglyph on the side of your camera is where the sensor is. So you really want your eye level to where that sensor is and the camera at eye height. So I have the 35 millimeter Rokinon CinePrime on the C200. And I'm gonna just shift it a little bit to where it's level with the corner of the window and that particular light stand. And then what I'm gonna do is outstretch my arms straight from my body and try and get that same frame that I see on the camera. And I mean, outstretched with the my thumbs out is pretty much giving me the same field of view as the 35 mil. So I know that if I do this on set, if I want the frame to be that big, I mean, this is sort of useless because how far this is from your body. But I know if I have my hands outstretched, pretty much directly out from my shoulders, not far out or close together, that with the frames up, I'm getting pretty much the same field of view as this 35 millimeter on the super 35 millimeter sensor of the C200. Let's swap the lens and try another. Now I have the 50 millimeter on the camera and I'm gonna try and, so still hands outstretched, with maybe two or three fingers gap between the thumbs is giving me pretty much a 50 millimeter. So now we have a 16 millimeter on here, really wide. I mean, I'm seeing pretty much from the corner of the room to this corner of the room. So my hands pretty much diagonally out from my body with that same thing. But it's coming down to about there. Pretty much if my fingertips are level to my shoulders and my hands are at a 45 degree angle, that's the frame I'm gonna get. Okay, now we have the 85 and it's pretty much just the camera. It is the traditional finger frames here. My hands outstretched from my body. If I'm on an 85, I can find what my frame will look like. I can move in and out and, you know, frame up without having to get the camera out, put it the right height, you know, put it the right height, put the right lens on. I know what I'm gonna get when I do this, that it's gonna be on this camera with this lens. This is what I'm gonna see. So last but not least, I've put my cheap $100 zoom on here and zoomed it all the way into 300 mil. It's pretty much just getting the camera itself. For me, for that, it's sort of like, you know, if I make a circle out of my thumb and forefinger and push it all the way out from my body, that's what I'm seeing. That, you know, this field of view for me, for my arm distance and my size hands, that field of view is a 300 mil lens on this camera. So these aren't gonna work for everyone, but I really encourage you to learn what your lenses look like. Some of the key things you wanna do are, you know, get the camera at eye height, get your eyes level with the sensor mark on the camera. And then, you know, just put on a bunch of different lenses. Using a zoom is way easier than different primes, but I have this set of primes, so I wanted to actually familiarize myself with those. And then just go through and put each one on, find different finger shapes, different hand shapes, different hand positions, write them down on your iPhone, and then know that when you do this, this is what that lens is gonna give you. Hopefully that was helpful for someone out there. Thanks very much for watching. Leave your questions in the comments, and I will see you next time.